Good afternoon. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Don Leach, Clerk of the Executive Council, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to a historic day, the swearing-in of the 24th Premier of Manitoba, this province's first woman Premier. Mesdames et messieurs, bonjour, je m'appelle Don Leach, Greff de Conseil Exécutif. J'ai le grand plaisir de vous souhaiter la bienvenue à cet événement historique pour assentement le 24e Premier ministre de notre province, la première femme à occuper ce poste au Manitoba. And those of you who choose may applaud in French. Before we begin, I would like to acknowledge that today's ceremony is taking place on Treaty No. 1 territory, the traditional lands of the Ojibwe, Cree, Dene, and Dakota people, and the homeland of the Métis Nation. We acknowledge that northern Manitoba includes lands that were and are the ancestral lands of the Inuit. So I'm going to ask you now to please rise for the entrance of the Premier-designate, joined by 17-year-old bagpiper Nora Eldridge of the St. Andrew's Society Pop-Up Pipers. Please be seated. I would now like to call upon Elder Billy Shibler to give us a blessing.
Buju, Vawakiki Ekweishnakas, Ojitak Tutem. Greetings. I'm so honored to be here. This is such an exciting, historic day to have our first female Premier of Manitoba. And it is no mistake that we are all here at this time together. And this is so exciting. We're in the heart of Turtle Island in Winnipeg here. I too want to acknowledge the traditional territories of our First Nation brothers and sisters, as well as the homeland of the Métis. I thought very hard about what I would bring today, and I know that I'm given a few minutes to just speak and bring blessings, but I have an opportunity here for the first time and probably only time to bring words of advice to our new Premier. And I just always am reminded of the traditional teachings that we follow, and that is that one of love. And thinking about the love of Manitobans, the love of the people, as well as courage, courage in all of the work that lies ahead and the courage that brought you here to begin with. Also, to think about the truth that is undeniable, and standing in your truth no matter what lies ahead. I think about the teachings of honesty, and that is what holds your integrity intact, and that may be challenged many, many times throughout your tenure. I also am thinking of courage, and the courage that you will carry in all that you do, but also the wisdom that you will need to make the decisions that will work best for this province and all of the people that are here, that celebrate you today and are there behind you in all of that you do. We are honored as Indigenous people. Our prophecies are that it is time for the women to take lead. And in our traditional, original communities, we had the women that made the rules. It was the men that enforced them. It was the women that chose the leaders. And so today, to have a woman in that lead role in Manitoba is so monumental to us. We celebrate it. I've come to know Heather as a very beautiful, gentle, courageous person, and we celebrate this. We celebrate all that lies ahead. The teacher of humility is one that says, you know nothing and you understand even less. And it's a harsh teacher, but it's one that says to us that we always need to be open to learning. And that's so important in all that we do. And no one would expect you to have all of the answers as you move forward, but we're there to help you in whatever way we can. And so the clan mothers, with our hundreds of years of cumulative wisdom, offer our support in any way that we can. So don't ever hesitate to call on us. I ask that in all that you do, that no matter what your spiritual beliefs are, that every day that you give thanks for the journey that you're on, and let your spirit guide you, because your spirit will never guide you wrong. And so today I ask that we pray, Creator, please watch over our new premier. Please guide her in a way that holds her strong and holds her protected in the safety of your love. Please help her to be all that she is meant to be in this honor that she's been given, and please help all of those that are around her to support her and her family in a good way. We ask that you watch over her. Miigwech, aho, all my relations.
Thank you, Elder. Now I'd like to ask you to please rise for the playing of the Viceregal Salute in the presence of Her Honor, the Honorable Janice C. Filmon, Lieutenant Governor of Manitoba. Please be seated. I now ask the Premier-designate to come forward and read the oath.
Okay, thank you. I, Heather Dorothy Stefanson, do solemnly swear that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors according to law, so help me God. I, Heather Dorothy Stefanson, do solemnly swear that I will duly, faithfully, and to the best of my knowledge and ability, perform and fulfill duties and requirements of the Office of Executive Counselor for the Province of Manitoba, to which I have been appointed, and so long as I shall continue to hold that office without fear or favor, so help me God. I, Heather Dorothy Stefanson, do solemnly swear that I will duly, faithfully, and to the best of my knowledge and ability, perform and fulfill the duties and requirements of the Office of President of Executive Council, Minister of Intergovernmental Affairs and International Relations for the Province of Manitoba, to which I have been appointed, and so long as I shall continue to hold that office without fear or favor, so help me God.
Please be seated. No, I'm sorry. Sorry. I'm supposed to ask you to rise, but you're already risen. So we're now at the point where I want to thank Her Honor for having been with us today and for everything she's done for us. So please be seated. So, ladies and gentlemen, It is my great pleasure to introduce the Honorable Heather Stefanson, 24th Premier of Manitoba, President of the Executive Council, and Minister for Intergovernmental Affairs and International Relations. Premier.
Please be seated. Oh, colleagues, friends, and family, I'm just so honored to be here today. Elder Shibler, that was a beautiful opening prayer. So much, thank you so much for everything that you do. Your clan mothers, just amazing things in our province, and I'm just so humbled to have you here with us today. Thank you. I stand before you today as Manitoba's 24th Premier. This was something that was once unthinkable. I reflect on the many people who have paved the way to make this possible, and I promise that our government will embrace their values of equality, inclusivity, and understanding. I reflect on Edith Rogers, a proud Métis woman who became the first female elected to the Manitoba Legislative Assembly. I reflect on her daughter, Margaret Konance, who became the first woman in Manitoba elected as a Member of Parliament. I reflect on the legacy of my friend and mentor, Bonnie Mitchelson, the first woman to lead Manitoba's Progressive Conservative Party and a distinguished cabinet minister who worked tirelessly to attract and retain new immigrants to our province. But most of all, I think of my mother and my grandmother, who made me into who I am today. As the first woman elected to serve as the Premier of Manitoba, I am proud to stand on their shoulders. And while I may be the first woman to hold this office, I take this oath confident in the knowledge that I will not be the last. And while the past can be an inspiration, it can also create and reopen wounds. The discovery of unmarked graves on the sites of former residential schools has shaken our province to its core, prompting a necessary reflection on the sins of the past and a renewed commitment to reconciliation. Our government is committed to listening and learning from First Nations leaders, elders, and Indigenous families as we advance reconciliation together. During my time in cabinet, I had the honor of working with the clan mothers, elders May Louise Campbell and Jamie Goulet, to advance their vision of healing for Indigenous women and girls. And I'm honored to have one of the clan mothers here with us today. Thank you, Elder Shibler, for being part of this service today. The clan mothers' healing village is a model of reconciliation in action, a place where Indigenous women and girls can recover from exploitation and violence and forge a new life rooted in their Indigenous culture and identity. The voices of these Indigenous elders and families are the voices of the future of reconciliation in our province. I look forward to learning from Indigenous Manitobans and working together to heal the wounds of the past and forge a new path forward. We must also heal from the COVID-19 pandemic, which has affected the lives and livelihoods of every Manitoban. Our communities have been fragmented without the ability to gather together, and our families have lost too many of their loved ones. This terrible virus has overwhelmed our healthcare system and harmed our economy. Thankfully, Manitobans have done what they always do. They have stepped up to help their fellow citizens. As of today, over 86% of eligible Manitobans have rolled up their sleeves and gotten the vaccine, saving lives and protecting our healthcare system. To Manitobans who have chosen to get vaccinated, I want to say to you, thank you. Because of you, we have been able to lift many of the public health restrictions, allowing our business owners to reopen their restaurants, movie theaters, and retail stores to thousands of customers. Because of you, our children are back to school for in-person learning, and our loved ones in long-term care are able to once again see their families. Because of you, we have been able to work with faith leaders so they can safely welcome Manitobans back to their houses of worship. And because of you, we have been able to join True North Sports and Entertainment and the Winnipeg Football Club to welcome thousands of fans back to cheer on our Winnipeg Jets and our Grey Cup champions, the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. But while we're finally seeing the light at the end of the tunnel, the COVID-19 pandemic has created and exposed new challenges in our healthcare system and our economy. The redirecting of healthcare resources to respond to COVID-19 created significant surgical and diagnostic backlogs that are hurting the health of our seniors and vulnerable Manitobans. The significant challenge we faced in our personal care homes exposed flaws in our long-term care system, showing that our seniors are not always receiving the respectful and dignified care that they deserve. And our overwhelmed intensive care units demonstrated that we need a system that can better adapt to the public health crisis. Our government will take immediate action to address these challenges. In the coming weeks, we will establish a task force to clear the surgical and diagnostic backlogs and enhance our ICU capacity. And we will do right by our seniors by implementing every recommendation in Dr. Lynn Stevenson's review of long-term care in our province. COVID-19 has also done untold damage to Manitoba's economy. Many small businesses have closed, and our hospitality sector is facing unprecedented challenges. Manitoba employers are finding it difficult to attract and retain workers, creating critical labor shortages that are dragging down Manitoba's productivity. We need to listen to our business leaders, small business owners, and our young Indigenous and new Canadian entrepreneurs about what they need to start and grow their businesses. To the extent that government is impeding their productivity and growth, we need to get out of their way and let them run their businesses. Over the coming months and years, that is exactly what our government will do. We will listen to our business community and create the conditions for economic growth. And we will reduce unnecessary barriers to success for our small and medium-sized businesses, allowing them to continue to employ thousands of Manitobans. I grew up in a family that is dedicated to public service. My mother was a citizenship court judge who administered the oath of citizenship to countless new immigrant families. My father was an accomplished business person who twice ran to represent the people of Fort Rouge in the Manitoba Legislative Assembly. I spent my afternoons and evenings participating in these rituals, the oath of citizenship and that speech at the door as we knock on those doors of Manitobans. Both require humility and a commitment to a cause greater than oneself. I have spent a lifetime knocking on doors because I believe in everything that this country and this province stands for peace, for prosperity, and human rights for all. I promise that I will always be humble in the pursuit of that cause. I promise that I will always listen to you, the people of Manitoba. And I promise that in 2 years, when this government seeks a renewed mandate, you will see yourself in our priorities and our vision. I will work every day to gain and maintain your trust. This is my mission, and together we will accomplish great things for this great province of ours. Thank you very much.
Seated, please. Thank you very much, Premier. Great words, thank you. I want to acknowledge our pianist extraordinaire, Cameron Friesen. We have one small additional request of all of you. Before the ceremony officially concludes, I ask that we stand for the playing of our national anthem, O Canada. Please rise. Thank you all very much for attending this afternoon. This concludes today's ceremony.